Gezi, congratulations. I can see by the smile on your face. That means a lot more than you did in round one.
Yeah, obviously I played a lot better there. Felt a lot more comfortable. And yeah, certainly for two legs, I felt like I was unbeatable. And even though John was playing, I thought fantastically well. But yeah, I'm happy to go over the winning line and with a good performance as well.
Obviously coming into the tournament, everyone made stuff of your record here, not being good. Having gotten over that first hurdle, did that relax you so much?
Yeah, it's just that first game every single time. It doesn't matter if it's you or if it's in any other tournament, winning the first game is the biggest hurdle and always the toughest one. And even though I won scruffy and was probably a little bit lucky, sometimes you need that. And yeah, I was happy to be in the second round and yeah, I was a lot more comfortable today.
When you said that, yeah, you felt unbeatable, was that at the end of the second set when you just literally couldn't miss?
Yeah, I thought the first set, second set, I was playing brilliant, but also John was as well, which makes it even better when you're up two sets and knowing someone's playing probably the best day of all year as well against you. And yeah, going back 2-0 and thinking, yeah, if I just put pressure on him now in the next set and go 3-0 up, I'm not losing this game. And I think he missed a couple of doubles in that set and let me off, but I was happy.
We saw from Instagram Christmas Eve you were flued up, so where did that performance come from?
I don't know. I haven't got a clue. I have had a few cough sweets and I stopped taking Lemsip 3 days ago, so I don't know if they were banned or anything. I didn't know. But yeah, I've filled myself full of the legal products that I could to try and fight it off. I'm not 100%, but I play pretty well, and when I am 100%, then hopefully I can play a little bit better.
Coming into the tournament, you were the second favourite, but with that performance, have you sent a marker to everyone else saying, hang on a minute, I'm actually the favourite to win this?
No, I don't think so. On the day, any one of these players can play like I, if not better, but I can play a lot better than I as well. I know it's just on the day, and you know, it doesn't mean that because I play like that, I'm going to go and do that again against Simon. I'm realistic. I need to be, it's on the day, and I need to be on my toes every single day as well.
Are you happy that the tournament started properly? And what I mean by that is it's games come thick and fast now. You haven't got big gaps between them. Is that a good thing for you?
I don't know. I haven't been in this tournament that this far before, so I'm in the unknown. So, yeah, it's nice now to play again tomorrow, Sunday, and hopefully Monday. So, yeah, if I'm still here Wednesday, I'm happy.
Gezi, pleasure. Thank you.
It's not often that players 2-0 down, average 107. What do you think?
Yeah, so I mean, I've been in that position where I've played out of my skin and been not set wise, but I could have been 3-1 or 4-1 down in the game, and you just like, how is this possible? But yeah, I was playing well as well, and he probably knew that, or he certainly knew that I was playing well. But yeah, it's just one of those things, and he probably thought if he kept playing the way he was, that he was going to have chances. He did have chances and he didn't take them, and I'm fortunate for that.
Do you think if he did get a hold in that third set and nailed the double, do you think maybe he would go back into it?
Yeah, because I could hear the crowd getting into it as well. I'm like, oh, please, no. It's easy when you're in front and the crowd's not on your back, but as soon as someone, you know, if you're level game or it's 3-all, then, you know, I'm not just playing John, I'm playing the crowd as well, and they're on my back. It's nice just to have a clear run and not let them get involved as well.
Cheers,
no worries.
Just to clarify on the flu, is there any danger of you perhaps not being fit enough to play today?
No, I'm a rugby player, man. I'll play with a broken leg if I can. Well, I was a rugby player. But nah, I'm always going to go up there, give 100%, no matter how I feel, and I never make excuses. Apart from last round, it was quite hot the last round, but yeah, I was a bit
so
more comfortable.
No danger of you ever thinking?
No. For the flu, no. You have to cut my arm off to stop me playing.
And just a word on Fallon, obviously she's out now. What have you thought of her?
Ah, she's been fantastic. The first round, I thought that the crowd were on Ted's back and sort of helped her along, but since then, she probably deserved to win against Mensah, and today she was fantastic again. And yeah, she's a credit to the game, and there's a lot of publicity for her and for the game as well, which is good.
Yeah. And obviously Simon, hell of a rejuvenance now. He seems like a different player compared to, say, almost 9 years ago when he got to the final against
Simon Whitlock. Oh, yeah, I haven't seen any of his game. I didn't watch that game earlier on, and I heard Mervyn should have been 2 or 3 sets up, but you know, like I said, every game's different. Simon could go out and hit the ball off a wall next round, I could be absolutely rubbish, but I'll just go into the next game and hopefully I'll play the same as I did today.
You the kind of player who enjoys getting momentum, getting wind in your sails when you get deep into a tournament?
I believe that you need a little bit of rubber the green as well. I know in 2014 when I won my tour card, I could have gone out early on and people missed starts against me, and then you know, 6 years down the line, I'm up to number three in the world. So you need a little bit of luck along the way, and I certainly had that in the first round, and hopefully I can just ride a bit more.
Do you feel like you sent out a bit of a message to MVG? That's the big blockbuster that everyone wants to see.
Nah, he's on, honestly, I hope he gets to the other, gets through to the final. I hope I do, because I don't want anybody else to jump above me in the rankings. So if I don't win it, I want him to win it. But yeah, I don't. Michael's a fantastic player, by far the best player in the world, and yeah, it'd be nice to get to the World Championship final against him and win it. That would just be.
He sort of, you know, focuses on himself quite a bit, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He didn't look at any. Do you think he was watching tonight?
Well, he's practicing backstage. He probably kept one eye on it, but yeah. I know he probably doesn't. A lot of players probably don't bother him, but I think I'm in his head a little bit.
Yeah. Living rent-free in his head tonight. I know you had a couple of boos out there this evening, but obviously Wales is backing you until the bitter end. Do you have anything to say to your fans back in?
Yeah, obviously I have a lot of support. I don't do Twitter. My wife does Twitter, but all over Instagram today, and a lot of people from Wales are supporting me, and a lot of English people as well, and unbelievable how many German people are supporting me, and I appreciate every single one of them, not just from Wales, but England, Germany, and all over Europe and the rest of the world. I appreciate it.
Well done for tonight.
No worries. Thank you.